today's video, I'm discussing about VAR, value at risk. Now, this is a topic which is frequently examined in AFM exam. Now, over here, basically what I have seen from my experience that students, they basically struggle with the understanding of VAR. Although they can do the calculation really well, calculation is quite easy, but they don't know the meaning of VAR. That is a major problem for most of the students, which I have seen from my experience. So today, what I will be doing is I will make you guys understand the meaning of VAR, what is actually VAR. Okay. So before I move on to this topic, I want to give, I will be discussing some brief concept about mutual funds. Now, what mutual fund does is, mutual funds, they will be basically pooling the cash from the people and then they will invest those funds in different places. And then after that, they will be distributing the return to the investor. Now, obviously, they will keep some of the return with themselves as well. Okay, so basically what they do is they will basically manage a diversified portfolio. Let's say one of the mutual fund is offering a return of 10%. Now, if I go and invest in government bond, so let's say it is offering a return of 6%. So now the question is how they are able to offer a return of 10%. Okay, so what mutual fund does is they will not invest all the money in one single place, but instead they will be making investment in different places. Like they will invest some of the money in government bond, they will invest some of the money in shares, they will invest some of the money in bonds, etc. Okay, so they will invest some money in high risky areas like shares, they will invest some of the money in low risky areas, and they will be investing some money in medium risk areas. So mutual funds, they will be maintaining a diversified portfolio of investment. Now, even those mutual funds, they are also facing the risk that investment value may decrease. Okay, now you have invested funds with them. So they're also facing the risk that investment value may decrease. So that's why every portfolio manager, they will be computing VAR. Okay, so VAR will tell you the maximum loss that you can suffer on every $1 invested. Okay, so it will tell you the maximum loss that I can suffer if I invest $1. So if I invest $1, so what is the maximum loss that I can suffer? So this question will be answered through VAR. Okay, so it will tell you what is the maximum loss that you can suffer if I invest $1. Now let's say your answer from VAR is 0.4. So it means that if I invest $1, so I can face a maximum loss of how much? 40 pence. Similarly, if your answer from VAR is 0.2, so it means if I invest $1, so the maximum loss that I can suffer on my investment is 20 pence. Okay, so that is basically determined with the help of this formula, which you can see over here. That is S into T into confidence level value. Now S is basically the standard deviation, T is the holding period of your investment. Now this confidence level value, this is something that you must be knowing how to compute it. Although in the past exam, if you look at the past exam, so many times the examiner have asked the students to compute VAR on confidence level value of 90%, 95% and 99%. So mostly what student does is they basically learn the values of confidence level value at 90%, 99% and 95%. But we never know, maybe apart from these three, he might ask you to compute confidence level value at any maybe at 85% or 80%. So you must be knowing how to compute a confidence level value. All right, so I hope you guys like the videos. So do subscribe my channel for more videos. Thank you.